Hi everyone, I'm Koshido and welcome to a new Path of Exile video. Today we are going to talk about the livestream happened yesterday for the 3.17 patch and the new endgame content. I will provide you the TLDR of what happened and you can find the link in the description for the full livestream. First of all, Zana is gone, she's leaving. Now Kirak is the new map master and they have improved how the map master missions work. Now they give you more league mechanic content and they are more rewarding. Also, there are a new currency type called Scouting Report and is used to reroll the Kirak Master mission and to ensure you a map with a specific reward type, for example, at least one Bridgestone mission or a unique map mission. The Awakener and the Conqueror endgame is gone. We can still fight those encounters like we do with the Shaper and the Elder. So we will be finding maps with the Conqueror influence in it. By running those maps instead of the normal map boss, we will find a Conqueror, and by killing that Conqueror, he will drop a fragment. By combining four Conqueror fragments, we can open the portals to kill the Awakener again. Awakener doesn't drop Awakened gems anymore, they are moved to the Maven encounters, and also some modifiers from influence gear are moved to the standard pool. For example, the plus 1 gems on the amulet. For the new endgame content, they added 2 new endgame bosses, the Zuring Exarch and the Eater of the World, with 2 new sub-bosses, one for each endgame boss. And by mapping, you will find their influence about on mid-tier maps. And once you find their influence, you can add the influence on any map like you do with Maven. By running subsequent map with the same influence, the amount of influence monster will increase till eventually you will find the sub-boss. By farming the sub-boss, you will eventually drop a quest item, which is an invitation to the endgame fight. And by entering the endgame arena, you will unlock the possibility to target farm that boss. So from now on, by farming tier 14+, you will be able to drop the invitation, which is an item, a tradable item. It's rollable with currency like the Maven's invitation, and you will be able to fight the endgame boss over and over. Of course, this is only a preview, we still don't know details, so as soon as the patch goes live, I will do my testing and eventually I will report to you with an updated video. Now we have a new Atlas, the regions are gone, the Watsons are gone. Now we have a bigger map, we start from the bottom and we work our ways toward the top. It looks like it's more complex, but it really isn't. There is no more leapfrog strategy. You can just run maps till you complete them all. Now, instead of the Watchstone, there are the Void Stones. They work similar, so there are only 4 of them. You will find them by killing the Uber Elder, the Maven, and the 2 new bosses. When you socket a Void Stone, you will increase the map level for all the Atlas, and by using 4 Void Stones, all your maps are level 16. Now they added a new currency to store sextant modifier. It's called the Surveyor Compass. So for example, you are rolling a Voidstone and you happen to find a Beyond. You want to keep that for later. You can now use the Surveyor Compass to store it, like we do in Bestiary. And you can also sell them or use it later on a Voidstone. They have changed the new favorite map system. Now you have specific tasks to complete to unlock the favorite map slot. There are 12 slots in total, and each slot functions as a 10 times multiplier of the chances to find the specific map. So for example, you can put 12 of the same map and have 120% times multiplier on the chance to find that map. Now that regions are gone, we have a new passive tree for the Atlas, a huge passive tree. You will get a point for each map you complete, a point for each bonus objective on the maps, and you will find about 117 points by only doing maps, and you will also find 20-30 points by doing bonus objective like boss killing and stuff like that. The tree is still unavailable, they will provide it to us in a few days, and as soon as it's available I will make an update video to see with you which part of the tree is good, which is bad. I will do some early game strategy, some late game strategy, we will see. With the new endgame, there is a new item mechanic tied to the bosses. So by farming the new influenced map, You will get a new currency that allows you to apply a new implicit modifier, which will replace the any existing modifier. Of course, you can't apply it to corrupted items. You can have one modifier for each of the new influence, so two in total. If one of the two implicit is a tier higher than the other, the item will be dominated by the boss tied to the higher tier modifier. And between the new currency, there will be a new Chaos Orb, new Exalted Orb, and new Annulment Orb, which will do different things based on the domination on the item. With the new bosses, there are new uniques tied to those bosses, and also there is a new Aspirational Jewel. Actually, they are two, one for each boss. They drop from the endgame bosses, the pinnacle bosses, and they only work together. Basically, the jewel has an Ashanasi keystone written in it, and if you have both jewels with the same keystone, you will unlock that keystone on your passive tree. But this only works for your class and different Ashanasi. For example, if you are a Deadeye, you can only use Raider and Pathfinder's one. Finally, let's talk a little bit about the new League mechanic, Arch Nemesis. They've made a simple League mechanic because of the new endgame content. Basically, you will find a frozen rare monster, and you can free it by adding an Arch Nemesis mod. This mod will give the monster a new modifier and a new reward. You will find maximum 4 frozen monsters through the map, and the reward is subsequent. That means if you add a currency reward type on the first frozen monster, the second, third, and fourth one will also have that reward. And when you find a new frozen monster, you can add a new Arch Nemesis modifier up to 4. If you don't add any new modifier, you can't free the frozen monster. It looks like there will also be recipes for those mods. That means if you add specific modifiers in a specific order, you will do a recipe, which will give you, I guess, a bonus reward or a bigger Nemesis modifier to use later. We still don't know these in detail yet. As soon as the patch goes live, I will do some testing and will provide you every info you need. Lastly, they added two new stash tabs, one for gems and one for flasks. Finally, there is also the new supporter packs, which looks very, very cool. And like always, there is a new boss event for the league start, which will be in Hardcore Solo Self-Found. And that's it, guys. I'm very excited for the new content. I can't wait to play the new endgame. Thank you very much for watching. Leave a like if you enjoyed the video. Subscribe if you want more content like this. And remember, stay safe, Exile.